Okay, we say two short halachot in chapter Shulchan Aruch, Ramach 248. This is actually very important. There's some people, they're very bashful. So it says, Adam shu'ar shenoten sadaqa yoter mi'arul lo yidah. Let's say somebody is a weak person. Some people, I unfortunately have this problem in my own family. To farsim again, ye nabegu hezar sal chodeto. Rahat kum. Some people, they don't know how to say no. So the guy is on minimum wage himself, but 500 rabbis a week come visit him, he give each one $50. So it says if somebody, the gabbai knows that this guy, he's very easy to take advantage and he's giving more than he can afford. The gabbai is not allowed to go. Right? If you're Jeff Bezos or the other guy, every day that each one is getting around worth $200 billion, yes. People like that can give unlimited charity, but somebody that's very meager and the gabbai knows that, is unethical for him to go, say, give the yeshiva or synagogue or kollel or mikveh or whatever community. The people that have more money should give everybody appropriately according to his means. So he says, actually, the guy, he doesn't want to look bashful. But let's say the gabbai goes, he knows in his synagogue, 90% of the people are millionaires. So he goes, each one give $1,000. But that guy over there, he shouldn't call upon him if he knows he doesn't have the money. It's forbidden for them to ask somebody that, ask khejalat mide, and he doesn't want to give, and he shouldn't be giving, because the halacha is, we should, all Jews should give 10% of their net income to charity. But if you yourself don't have enough money to live a normal life, and you're below standard of living, then that 10% could go back to yourself. Yeah, what do they say in Farsi? Cheragike. Yeah, so that's why. So, and it says these gabbais that are tough guys, and want to act macho, like a collection agency, and take money from people that really don't, cannot afford it, they're going to get punished in the next world. So everybody has their halacha. Usually 99% of the time, the problem we're dealing with, people have so much money that they're not giving enough. But you do have that problem also 1% of the time, that people are giving too much. That guy should... The next halacha I love, because it has to do with the floor you're sitting on right now. It says that, harotze lizkot et atzmo, if you want to be a true tzaddik, a true Jew, break your Yetzahara, and when you give something to the synagogue, don't give cheap stuff, give the best. Which means you could donate a Torah worth $5,000, you could donate a Torah worth $50,000 to the synagogue. Why give the cheapest one that's, you know, basically falling apart, you bought secondhand, if you can't afford the, you know, the good one, the one that's beautiful and wonderful. And it says that's why imbana beta tefila yenam beta yeshivato. So that's why there's a halacha that always the synagogue should be nicer than your own house, which means this was the first sin, one of the first sins mankind did. Cain and Hevel, Adam Harishon's two sons, right? The first one, Cain, he brings his garbage and gives it to God. God says what? I reject that. I don't want that. This is one of the most important things. That's why he says, "Hey Chil Rav, if you have somebody that's hungry, don't feed him your garbage. If there's a Jew that's hungry, give him the same Shabbat food that you serve from your thing. This is wrong to think, oh, since I'm giving charity or I'm giving money to Kenisa, I'm going to just donate my garbage." So it says, if you want to dedicate something to the synagogue, so that's why it says in Navi, kol chelef laHashem. Everything fat and juicy and good is to Hashem. Hashem doesn't like it when, like Cain, Adam's son, he gives his garbage to Hashem. Hashem in the Torah, that's one of the first lessons. He says, I don't accept it. Hevel came and he gave what? His firstborn, his best, and God accepted. So that reminds me, one day we used to live in Pico Robertson. So Harav Ben David, one of the biggest rabbis in the world, our Rebbe, he came and he saw in our house we have marble floor. So he said, "I Hikmatja, Mr. Hikmatja, the carpet belongs in your house. The marble, which is better, belongs where? In the synagogue. That's when my father bought the synagogue. One of the first things he did was he put granite. The floor that we're sitting on right now is granite, because this is very important. If all our, everything we have, our life, our wife, our health, our wealth is from Hashem, then we have to give back the best. Not big. So therefore, if we give charity, if we give donation, give the best, give the juiciest, give the finest, because it's all from Him anyways. We're just giving back for everything we have is from Him. And when we give the garbage, God forbid, it looks like, you know, it's not from Him. Rabbi